themes of a megaverse, fantasy, politics, arranged marriage, and vampire, werewolf, and human coexistence. That is Bride by Ali Hazelwood. Mayong adlaw mga amigo, my name is Moon or MJ, and welcome back to my channel. And today, I'm going to talk about Bride by Ali Hazelwood. So, I've read this book in about 2 days, which goes to show that I enjoyed reading this book. However, I only rated this book 3.5 to 4 stars, which can be explained in the following breakdown. The very first thing which I wanted to talk about are the characters. So, personally, the characters in this book are not that fleshed out in my opinion. Even how they look completely went over my head. All I can remember is that Lau is huge and muscular, while Misery, on the other hand, have purple eyes. In case you didn't know, Misery and Lau were the names of the main characters of this book. So for their personality, I find it to be okay. Misery pretty much has a common character personality in a sense. However, I would have loved if we delved in more about the conflict within herself, since she was after all sent as a hostage or collateral to the human world. Don't get me wrong, there is internal conflict written in this book, but I would have loved it if it was explored more into detail, because I really love it if the character has some sort of a deeper dive in the book, if the writer has done a deeper dive for a certain character. I really enjoyed reading that because I just love connecting with the character and the way they handle their thought process. So Lau, on the other hand, is a gentle giant in my mind. He's kind and sweet and just overall romantic, which I loved reading. He's not pushy and respected Misery's boundaries, which I actually love wholeheartedly. The second thing which I wanted to talk about is the plot and the world building. The world in this book was set in the United States, in which the vampires, humans, and the werewolves live in coexistence. They have boundaries in their territories and pretty much hostile if one of them will cross the said boundaries. Hostile meaning they're going to off the other like species if they went over their boundaries. Although I must say that I'm quite confused as to which states belong to each like faction. Like, it's not that explained in the book, and although I think there is a map, I'm not that good with maps. So when it comes to text itself, like, you can't deduce as to which state belongs to a faction. So the three factions have an ongoing passive aggressiveness going on, in which a family like of the higher ups of like each faction send a family members of theirs to be a collateral or hostage to the other team. For example, Misery, who was like a daughter of the biggest councilman in like the vampire society, she was sent as a collateral or hostage to the human world. However, it is not that explained properly as to how it works, what is the rotation is, because in this book, in the like the vampire realm, the collateral is a werewolf. So I'm expecting that in the werewolf part, the collateral is a human, but there is no human collateral in the werewolf part. So I really don't know how it circulates like around these three factions. For the plot, it circulated around the fact that Misery was looking for her friend Serena, who had gone missing without a trace. I say the word circulated because it's the main driving force as to why Misery did the things that she did. After all, the reason as to why she married Lau in the first place is the fact that she is looking for her friend who had gone missing, and the only trace that she can have is the note that Serena wrote like in her notebook with the name of like L.E. and then Lau's surname. I must say, however, that the plot and the pacing was quite lukewarm. There are facets of politics and dirty games that were mentioned in the plot, but it was not elaborated enough. I mean, I do know that this is a romance book, so the book focuses on the romance, but I am very much intrigued with how the entire social system in the book works, and I would have loved it if it was mentioned and talked about more. Like, I am a sucker for politics. That's the reason why I love Game of Thrones in the first place, because I really enjoy the banter of like the people with the power. Like, I really enjoyed those types of things. Even in the last part, in which Misery found Serena was lukewarm, there is no thrill at all, just a voice in my head like, okay, that happened. In addition, I am not at all a fan as to how the fight scene was abruptly cut off. There is a fight scene in the ending. It was abruptly cut off. It was not described as to how it happened. Instead, it was described as to how it ended and what happened afterwards. However, all in all, I still enjoy the flow of the story. Like, I did rated this book 4 stars. The last thing which I want to talk about are the Omegaverse themes. So before we went into this topic, I must start this by saying that I have been in AO3, fanfiction.net, and Wattpad ever since I was 10 years old. So to say the least, I am quite familiar with how Omegaverse works. And not to mention, most of the books that I have read last year are Omegaverse. You can see it in my Goodreads. So when I say that saying that this book is an Omegaverse book is somewhat of a reach, it is quite true. Because although there are Omegaverse themes in this book, this is not a pure Omegaverse book. There are no heats, there are no omegas, there are no betas, and the only thing that is remotely connected to the Omegaverse world is the scent and knotting, which I'm not going to explain in this video because it's quite uncomfy to talk about those topics. Personally, this book is more of a soulmate type of thing instead of Omegaverse. In addition, I have seen a lot of people talking about the spice in the book, but it's not spicy at all. It's only average. So yeah, I have read a lot worse. So yeah, that's basically it for the video. I really enjoyed reading this book. I rated this book 4 stars on Goodreads. Also, if you have read this book, kindly comment as to what are your thoughts and let's discuss. That's basically it for this video. I hope I'm going to see you in the next one. Bye guys.